very well, I think, should be this case. Pantheon as a jungle also still combos really well with Taliyah, whether you lane with it or not. But it's the same idea. It relegates Closer to only farming his own camps, not setting up any of the lanes like we see here on top side.
Flash into the stun. Flash comes out from Haunter, but Cloud9 are still looking for it, and the spear in the
anchor relationship that are very important.
Well, talking about that relationship, they're looking to get awfully familiar with each other here in the mid lane as Nissi. But he finds himself in a spot that might be dangerous. The red trinket finds him out. He goes for the showstopper, but remember, Zet has no mobility. As soon as the showstopper comes out, there's no other way through him except trying to fight back, but that's not happening. Good collapse. Has had so much control over the buffs this game. They have taken every single buff except for the flash into a skewer, but he will not have the distance for it. But if we're talking about distance, Taliyah is able to close it there with the wall. Here comes the Pantheon. This is the composition. This is how oppressive this combination can be. Better of Nissi in that one. But as you said, it's all about the bottom lane. It's all about the place and that first turret.
They're pressuring you on every objective, on every side. Now they're between your turrets, diving your Aphelios.
Oh, the haymaker
last on this one.
I would normally feel bad for him because he wasn't even overextended, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Like he was super safe. But considering he's
ate the eye.
So I remember the lore. I don't know where I saw this, but
Mega Crab. Well, that Mega Crab has been acquired here yet again. Cloud9 have
with workers. And if you get shot once and you have to go back to the other side, they just need a couple more
right next to each other, unfortunately. As another 1v1 is going to be happening here in the top side jungle. Not a 1v1 for long. Here come the reinforcements. It's Taliyah and...
You don't put that on your resume, Flowers. I win the 1v1.
I won a 3v1 against the guy isolated in the jungle by the red buff.
Yeah.
Well, unfortunately, as mentioned, this means soul point. It means everyone after this practically needs to be contested or else you get
away. Cloud9 pretty much always play side lanes. They've got big advantage. You see Taliyah up there. You're shoving the wave first on both sides. And then, coming straight through the river, it's just picture perfect.
It's Taliyah and Pantheon. Blabber goes into the fight, immediately popping the stasis, making sure they're not able to return the aggro onto him. However, now he's going to be found by the CC of the Sejuani ult. He goes on a rampage, finding the kill onto the Aphelios. Closer trying to get himself out, and it's Licorice into the back lines. It's Pyke finding the spot with the X. As soon as Haunter tries to make some sort of a move, he is just more money.
Come through, Cloud9 wearing purple.
Golden Glue, Golden Guardians, there's not enough gold in Scrooge McDuck's basement to get these guys in through a fire. You win in the next 2 minutes, which is your Baron power play, which is entirely possible given the lead.
Time and allow the rest of the squad to push over on the bottom half. There's the initiation, though.
Nice engage coming out from the Golden Guardians. This is going to be taken very low. Shutdown for FBI. Licorice takes him out in the back line. And the lead is just too much. Even though they start off with a kill onto the Cloud9 mid laner, it's just not a fight you can win from 10,000 gold behind. And C9, kill three.
And Licorice lives after diving under that turret at set.
Just set things.
That's going to leave them alone with the inhibitor turrets. Cloud9 will take them both. Golden Glue and Hoohee. Up to them to try and defend the rest of it here. I think inhibitors into Mountain Soul is a play here from Cloud9. They don't really have enough health, enough of an advantage to finish the game. As you said, that Mountain Soul is just going to kind of be the cherry
for once.
Yeah, quietly actually, Sven on the Syndra has had a really
toy. As C9 will push down that top side here yet again. Who he's going in, the chain CC coming out, the damage going down, and Sven will barely walk away. Vulcan is now the target, and that's another shutdown going over to FBI. Blabber goes unstoppable. It is support for support as Cloud9 now finds himself on the wrong side of the enemy walls. Or are they? Facebreaker into Haymaker. Licorice is on a killing spree, and Golden Guardians are on the run. One more punch would do it, but they don't even need that to take Haunter out. Blabber is dominating. Cloud9 is four men strong in the enemy base. They've got the opportunity to take that mid lane inhib, and they can move right back up to the top side.
Yep, inhibitor is down. What a big play again from Licorice as Golden Guardians look to be able to try and fight their way out of it, but he just turns it right around, got a perfect stun. Now he's healed back up with regeneration and looking for another play. All three, now they get their Baron.
You can see pings coming out from Cloud9 onto Haunster, who was close by around the Krug pit, but he wasn't looking to contest Baron. He was literally just for minion waves. Are nothing to mess around with, as Golden Guardians surely only have one fight left, and who he has decided it is time to go. A very nice initiation will take down the Cloud9 bot laner. Licorice goes into the backside, and he's on a rampage. With FBI and Golden Glue down, the carries are out of the picture, and Cloud9 has absolutely crushed the Golden Guardians. Haunt is gonna jump around, do some gymnastics with the sword. It don't matter none. The inhibitors fall, the turrets fall, the Nexus falls, and Cloud9 is right back to their usual tricks.